life or my house and my land? What care I for my treasure? What care I for my new-wedded lord? I'm off with a raggle-taggle gypsy.
Welcome to Posh Nosh.
Hello.
Today we're making paella. Simon's tennis coach, Jose Luis, is coming to lunch. Show us your backhand, darling.
Hands full.
And to make him feel at home, we're making that classic Spanish dish. So, paella.
Well...
What?
No, nothing.
Right. Paella gets its name from the pan it's cooked in. We ordered our paella pan from the official Paella Pan website. There are many different kinds of paella, but today we're making Simon's favourite paella, Paella Valenciana.
Well, actually...
What?
It's paella.
Right. Paella.
Paella.
Paella. Right. You'll need chicken, mussels, garlic, onions, tomatoes, peas, red pepper, saffron, Italian risotto... Rice?
Rice. Rice is an English word.
Risotto... Rice, six giant prawns, plus Simon's magic ingredient, bataga.
Forget anchovies. Bataga is the cashmere of fish. It's the salted, sun-dried roe of mullet. It's from Sardinia, and it's as firm and moist as Tom Cruise after a hot bath. You can cut it into strips or grate it. It's so utterly grateable.
You can buy it from the bataga website.
But if you're serious... You'll buy it from the source, fish market at Caligari.
We do our bataga run every March.
Arrive at Caligari not a minute after 6 o'clock in the morning when the fishermen are still wet.
So, start with the mussels. You'll need to interrogate them several times over. Get their little beards off. I use this lovely brush which belonged to Simon's mother, Lady Marchmont. Well, her cook. She gave it to her cook. Two rows from Lady Marchmont. Christmas 1956. And it still works. They made things to last in those days. Then thrill your mussels open in hot bubbling water. What are we drinking with our paella, Simon, darling?
It's got to be a Viña Hernández Rioja Reserva 1994. It's around 20 quid, but don't be put off by the price, because sometimes the cheap ones are the best. Jose Luis keeps on at me about my sweet spot, when your ball just pings off your racket.
Of course, when he says it, it's sweet spot.
And it's the same thing with the wine. It should ping in your mouth. Sherry-ish nose, velvet mouthfeel, notes of cherry, strawberry, leather, and that gorgeous wood smoke and tobacco finish, like liquid Spanish fags. The first time Nigel Havers came to eat with us at the Quill and Tassel, he ordered this. So I call it Rioja del Havers.
He's a lovely chap.
He started with my shaved fennel.
So funny.
You didn't meet him?
No, but I mean...
You were in the kitchen.
So I was. Chicken. We use free-range organic homeschooled chicken from our friend Arthur Legg Bourke's farm.
Burke.
Burke's farm near Banbury.
We only pick out the happy ones. They don't have those awful Cliff Richard necks. You can taste when meat's been happy. Tell me you can't smell the happiness on that.
Oh, yes. Simon studied meat under Raymond Blanc.
Raymond Blanc is meat.
Yes. Now for the stock.
Those aren't giant prawns.
I think they are, darling.
No, they're not.
We make our own stock, but by all means buy stock cubes if you have low self-esteem. Keep a bone bowl handy. This is ours. Now I'm going to show you how to turn this...
Not giant.
...into this. Perfectionist. Pillage the bones and bury them in a pan with some gale force salt and pepper blasted celery and carrot. Excite the chicken, peas, tomatoes, onions and garlic all together in hot, slow virgin oil.
Morsel, please, Mummy.
Come on, there you go. Oh, darling. My boys, they're as bad as each other. Oh. This is us on our wedding day. be honest, I felt a bit dowdy next to those two.
Gorgeous beast.
Tumble into your paella pan with your risotto rice, embarrassed mussels, above average prawns, and gently gush till it completely obsesses the rice. That's your stock with the saffron in it. Stress your kneaded red pepper into grass blade strips and fan base onto the mixture. There. Now, let that sit for 2 to 3 minutes to let those wonderful ingredients talk amongst themselves. Oops, don't forget the bataga.
Closely shared, of course.
Shroud your pan in recycled aluminium foil and shelve it in your arga. This was my wedding present from Simon's mother, Lady Marchmont. She had this lovely thing in our house in Scotland for years and gave it to me. A good oven glove's worth its weight in gold. Simon misses her every day, don't you, darling?
Hmm.
But in a way, she's still with us. Anything you'd like to add, darling?
I've known what it's like to be truly loved. How many people can say that?
About 45 minutes, yes?
Yes.
And when it's done, let it settle for a good 10 minutes.
God, yes. Cooking really upsets food. José Luis. Muy bien.
Muy bien. There. See how much happier it is now? Last thing, check your seasoning.
Fine. Just need to put it into a nice serving dish.
Olé! Paella Valenciana.
That's nice.
Hi, José.
It's supposed to be served in the pan.
Right, yes, good. I'm learning all the time. Join us next week when we'll be strip searching broccoli.
What care I for a goose with a bed with a sheet turned down so bravely? For tonight I shall sleep in a cold open field.
From the Posh Nosh range, Costa Rican coffee-flavoured chocolate coffee beans.
Along with a raggle-taggle gypsy, though.